Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I've been meaning to make videos for the last few days, but the house mom and dad have been here, and we've been looking for a vehicle, trying to get a van, a passenger van, and I think we found the one we're going to get. We had one that we were really going to get, but there was something wrong with it, the first one, and then we've been looking at several others, and thank the Lord, we've been praying about it for 2 days. I ask you guys to pray about it, that we're going to buy it tomorrow. It's more expensive than the other one, but it holds, I think, 16 passengers, passenger van. I think that's what we're going to get. And then we've been praying about it. It's versus the truck we talked about before, because the children in the back of the truck, it's not really safety. And then if we keep using the truck on the coconut farm, it's going to get messed up. The vehicle will be useless quickly. It will be damaged from riding it on the farm. You're talking about riding it cross country and all this kind of, you know, through the, not on the road, in the coconut farm. So it'd easily be damaged and stuff. And it's not really, you know, our primary focus is not the coconut farm, but for the safety and the transportation of the orphans too. As a matter of fact, this summer, which is summertime here now, here at the end of March, in April, we'll be sending them to, we do our own vacation Bible school, but we also connect them with some of our feeding programs, those churches we do feeding programs with, they'll be doing some vacation Bible school. So we're going to put our orphans in there with them, and then we'll do our own also in the area for the neighborhood kids, like we've been doing every year around the orphanage. I ask you guys to pray about that. You know, we need a budget for all those things. You know, if I'm going to get a playlist of all the videos I've made live from, you know, from the orphanage, and I'm going to be going there Sunday too, and I'll make a new video. We have lots of new orphans, and I need to go through and make a report about the whole thing. But I've been making videos about the orphanages since we started. And those of you who've watched my videos, or if not, the link will be below here of a playlist of all the orphan videos where I was on location at the orphanage. Anyway, the land I bought had originally one house. If you watch my videos, you would know that, you will know it, or you can watch it. And then we built the new house, which is the orphanage. And I have been saying from the beginning that the old house one day would be our backup orphanage when the first one is full. So we're at that point. And I also, if you've been watching my videos, you will know that my sister-in-law and her husband, my brother-in-law, is the one who's been fabricating, because he's a welder and a driver. And he fabricated the swing set we have at the orphanage and things like that. He does all the welding and maintenance and at the orphanage. And he also, we took all these truckloads of dirt, rock, gravel mix and leveled the land, because the land, those of you watching my videos, you would know that the land had lots of mosquitoes. That's how Joshua originally got the dengue fever from this place where the orphanage is now. He was living there going to school during the week with his aunt and his uncle. That's my sister-in-law and her husband, the one who does the welding and all that. And so anyway, there have been not really Christians in the past, and the Lord had spoken to me that, hey, the Lord would use Joshua's ministry. A little child would lead them, not only for the orphans leading people to the Lord, their families and all that, but also that the family of my wife would be led to the Lord through the death of Joshua. So I haven't talked about it too much, but I've been dealing with all of my wife's relatives. She has some relatives who are Muslims. They married into Muslims, and then their kids, some of her cousins, are Muslims because their dad is a Muslim and different things like that. I've been working with all these different relatives of my wife through Joshua's ministry, like the where we have our farms, the manager of all of our coconut farms. It's my wife's uncle. He has his own coconut farms, and that's why I connected with him to manage our coconut farms, because it's right beside his. And he was not a Christian, and I've been working with him, his family. He has a family. And then on his coconut farms, he's got dozens of people who live on the coconut farms that are tenant farmers. All those people. You know, that's the next place we're going to make a new orphanage, by the grace of God. This is the next place we're going to start doing a feeding first. So I need to do a report on all these things that the Lord's been having me do. But anyway, for the last 2 days, we've been praying and talking and planning. And so anyway, my sister-in-law and her husband, you know, just as the Lord had told me, they're starting to take orphans. And they're really becoming serious Christians, as I've asked you guys to pray for them. and now they have taken five orphans. All, you know, now, this week. And so I haven't had a chance to mention this in the video and talk about it because things have been moving fast. But, you know, praise the Lord for that. Things are looking good. The Lord is advancing in my wife's family with lots more of them becoming Christians. I haven't had time to talk about that, so I've been very busy working with all them because they're spread out over in different places on this island that's hours from here, and I've been visiting with them, evangelizing them, praying with them, all this kind of stuff, because those people God will use also to help with Joshua's ministry. As I mentioned, my wife's uncle is managing the land. My brother-in-law is just the welding, and he fabricated the playground. And, you know, he's a professional driver before, and now he's going to drive for the ministry. And he's going to be our second house dad. So God is bringing all these things together, brothers and sisters. And so anyway, I'm going to go there and make a video. That's why I'm making this quick video. I'm going to make the video of giving people a word, and the Lord's been showing me lots of cool stuff that I might even mention on here while I'm making this video, but that I'm way behind. But, you know, you got to do things in God's timing. But anyway, we need to build another bedroom on the orphanage and another bathroom. I'm going to go there and make a video on Sunday, but look, we've got two bathrooms, and then we got like whatever there is there now. We're going to have 20 kids, but right now we got like 16 kids there. 16 kids with two bathrooms, okay, counting the and then the house mom and dad too. And they have a little girl, 2-year-old girl. So it's not enough. And that's what I'm going to really mention on Sunday. I mentioned it now. We have got to build a new bathroom right now. The other house has one bathroom, and then we've got the five kids there plus the house mom and dad. And then there's one girl there too. They have one daughter there too. So it's not enough there. So in the old house, the original house that's on the land, which is the new orphanage, but the old house, the original house, we need to add, I'm going to build what they call a dirty kitchen. So if you've seen from my pictures, and I'm going to go there on Sunday and show it again, but on the back of the orphanage, we built this house, like a big kitchen, and then we're using a wood stove, okay, because we can get wood for free that falls off the coconut trees and stuff. We don't have to buy it versus using a propane tank. Our electricity is very expensive, and an electrical stove. So we made a stove out of cement, and we have a pipe going up through the roof. And then, anyway, so it's hot. It is hot in the Philippines. It's 100 degrees every day. So we have this outdoor kitchen. They call it a dirty kitchen. If you go to any old American house, any old American farmhouse, they also have a separate kitchen. It's the dirty kitchen because, it can easily catch on fire and all this kind of stuff, and it's so hot. In the States, too, before air conditioning, especially in the South, it's very hot, so we have that. In the old houses in the States. But anyway, this kitchen, it's got this real thick screen, you know, like on a screen door, you know, you got like the little tiny screen, and then you got a bigger diamond cut, thick metal screen. And so they call it a cyclone screen is on there. And then it's like the first 3 feet is like a wall, a cement wall. And then the top part is this, which I've talked about it before in my old videos and got it on there. It's like a wooden frame, and then it's got this screen. So anyway, in the orphanage, we're going to build a second story on that. You know, and we can do, how much is it going to be? Let's just say about $4,000 to $5,000. We can build a second story. It's a 16 by 16 room. We can build a 16 by 16, you know, one grand room on top of the dirty kitchen, a wooden structure with a metal roof and a new bathroom. And one bathroom upstairs in that room, and it's going to be about $4,000 to $5,000. And then the old house, which is the new orphanage, we want to build a dirty kitchen just like that one, and the two-story, you know, together all at one time. So together, you know, it's going to be say $6,000. It's cheaper to build them both at the same time. The orphanage, we built the first level first, and now we got to take off the roof, add the second level, and then put the roof back on. So the cost is not that much cheaper. Like I said, it's $4,000 to $5,000, and then the other one is say $6,000 for a whole structure. But, you know, with a bathroom inside of it. But I still want to build. We've got two bathrooms now, and we on the orphanage, the old orphanage, which is the new house. We need to add two. I want to add two more bathrooms right now, even because it's going to take how many months? 2 or 3 months to build that structure, and they're standing in line to use the bathroom now. And the house dad, of course, and mom just told me about it, but, you know, they didn't want to bother me with it, but it's a big priority. It's something we should have done from the beginning. I didn't, you know, I can't think of everything. Just as it happens, as I see the problem and know about it, then I can react. I mean, this is all, you know, as the Lord leads us and as things, you know, happen and through experience, then we say, hey, there's a need, let's do it. So in this case, I want to build two bathrooms, and that's going to be about $500 to build two cement walled bathrooms with a shower and a toilet, two on that house. And then I would want to put a single one, maybe. I guess I should probably go ahead and, we should probably go ahead and build a double on the other house, because we're going to need it. We're going to end up with 20 orphans over there. And if you do two, you know, at the same time, it's cheaper than doing, you know, because we can have like a common roof on it and stuff. We can reduce the cost. So basically, it was $800 to $1,000 to do four nice, say nice. I mean, it's not American standard. If you see the video of the ones that we have, the other ones we have, they didn't smooth the cement over the hollow blocks, they call, you know, the cinder blocks. But these, we're going to get that fixed too. The first carpenter didn't do it right. He didn't put cement over the hollow blocks or the cinder blocks. And then when it, you know, they will wear out faster, and, you know, you need to smooth them over so that, you know, like water, if it rains, can get in there and damage it and deteriorate the wall, and it will, you know, over not so many years, as opposed to if you have a smooth cement surface, then it will last for 30 years or whatever, 40 years, who knows, whatever. So that's why I say the immediate need we need to do is build bathrooms right now. And in the old house, which is the new orphanage, we don't have really indoor running water. We have a water spigot from, there's two different water companies in the area. And the one that we have there, for one thing, it's only outdoors. It's in front of the house. And number two, they only have water from noon till 9 p.m. at night. The new orphanage, we got the new water company that came through there, and now we have running water really 24 hours a day in the orphanage. The old orphanage, the new house, which is the old orphanage. So in the old house, which is the new orphanage, we need to get the right running water. So it's going to cost us it's like $100 to get that fixed, just for now. And then when we build that dirty kitchen on there, we're going to need a second water outlet in the dirty kitchen. And then they're doing their laundry outside, because we hang it outside, and they're doing their laundry under the running water outside. So I have another water connection, and that'll all be included in the value, the price of building the dirty kitchen and the upstairs pot top. So, you know, this is just really something, these things we need to do right now. Like I said, I'll go there Sunday and re-show the place from the location and show the new orphans. I need to go there and get all the new orphans. One of them is named Matthew, the same name as my son. And anyway, so this is all an answered prayer about the new house, mom and dad, answering the call, becoming Christians, answering the call of the Lord and all that. Stop being backsliders. And all that is a huge, huge thing, that because God told me he's going to do it. So it's God's answered his word, fulfilling his word and his promises to Joshua's ministry and all that. So all that's good. And so, you know, my rough estimate for all of these things is basically $10,000. And, I'm making this video and telling you guys and ask you guys to pray about it. Those who feel led by the Lord who donate, please help us out. This is kind of an immediate need that we need. I know we just bought the vehicle. And look, the vehicle is, like I said, it's a 14 or 15 passenger. Maybe it's 14 or 15, whatever it is. With kids, you can get more in there. But the point is that's, I've already thought about it, that, hey, that's going to carry the orphans that we've got if we jam them in there. But we probably, in the next year, we're going to end up with like 15 more orphans. So we probably got to buy another vehicle at the end of the year. So for the other orphanage. And then, by the grace of God, we're going to build more orphanages in other places. And we're going to need it all over again for all of those. But I know, and I ask you guys to agree with me, of course the Lord will provide. This ministry, especially the orphanage, is all the Lord's. This is the Lord's orphans, that the Lord is making them his children. This is God's thing, especially you talking, as the Bible says in James, that God's perfect religion is keeping yourself spotted from the world, and, you know, and help widows and orphans. And I know the Lord will provide, and the Lord will make a way. I've got lots more details and stuff to talk about, but this is just really the immediate thing that I want to get this money, by the grace of God, raised and get this done before I leave for the States on May the 17th. It's got 6 weeks. Well, I don't know if it'll be finished construction, but have the budget and have it in construction and, you know, almost finished or whatever before I leave, and have all the budget for it. So I gotta ask you guys to pray. I know that God will provide, the Lord will provide. That's why I'm making this video. And you know that I am just a facilitator of this thing. I am nothing. You know, the house mom and dads have a huge responsibility and a huge job that I probably couldn't do. And, you know, I would love to make videos of them giving their testimonies. Their English is maybe hard to understand sometimes because if you're not used to hearing a Filipino accent, but I want to get their testimonies and stuff too. You guys, if you guys could hear the testimony of the house moms and dads, if you guys could hear the kids, of course they can't speak English really, telling their story, you are one heartless person if you don't, you know, if you don't have a heart toward these orphans and stuff. It's just, you have to be like some kind of a evil person not to really have a broken heart for the life of these orphans. That's all I can say. And so I'm going to be busy. I'm going to be going there, and then I need to make on the joshuasministry.com, which we don't really, I never really talk about. We have a website, and then I have like a little bio and a picture of the orphans. I got to update that. I'm way behind with all these new orphans. But I've been so tied up with getting the vehicle and then, you know, now the facility and all that stuff. But I ask you guys to pray that God will give me the wisdom, the energy, the time, the priority of how I need to do this. You know, like I said, the bathrooms is the biggie right now. And the getting the running water right in the other house and up to some kind of a standard. This, you know, this is God's orphans and we need to have running water for them, you know. And, you know, we need to take care of what we've committed to do in the name of the Lord and what the Lord has called us to do. And some of you guys are called, we're partners in this to do God's will. And so that's why I know that, that those of you who are called by God that want to help us will help us and God will make a way. And so I just want to say thank you. I appreciate this. That you know, like I said, we're a team. I can't do this without you guys. And of course, with the Lord's guidance and those who, you know, when people give, the Lord said, if you give, it'll be given unto you in good measure, pressed down, shaken out, running together. Well, men give into your bosom. So anyway, I wanted to add on here a little nugget for those who watch this video, which will only be those who love Joshua's ministry. Did you know that on the, and I haven't got this all worked out in my mind, but the Lord told me to study it and I looked and it's true that, you know, there's still fragments of the covering of the pyramids that's on the Giza Plateau. And I didn't know this, but I knew that, that they were had coating on them before. There's like a limestone on the Great Pyramid. Anyway, check this out. The Great Pyramid that has a Sphinx in front of it, the original color was white. Then the second largest pyramid, the color was red. It's called the Red Pyramid. Then the third one was black. And the Lord had shown me when I first started dealing with the Antichrist and all that, when I moved to this city that I live in now, 2008 or 2009, the Lord was showing me like the Antichrist coming out of the Great Pyramid, like the Sphinx, you know, is the Antichrist or the image of the Antichrist coming out of that Great Pyramid and flying into the air, you know, the rise of the Antichrist from the pyramid. That was before all the riots started in Egypt and all that and the overthrow of their government. So when that started happening, I was like, well, that must be what the Lord's talking about. But think about the four horsemen of the apocalypse. The first one is white. And then the second one is red, and the third one is black, and I guess the last one is sorrel or greenish, sick-looking color or whatever. So I haven't got that part worked out about the sorrel one, okay, the greenish-looking one or grayish one. But the first three, it's kind of something I never thought about, and the Lord had showed me. And I made a video a long time ago where the Lord had given me a specific word and said that the judgment of the Lord cometh out of the Big Dipper, the Big Dipper. Now, I didn't know anything about. The Lord had told me also study Orion's Belt. And then I found out that the Great Pyramid and those other two pyramids on the Giza Plateau mirror, they're a mirror image of the position of Orion's Belt at the time the pyramids were supposed to be built or whatever, in those 2000-something BC, whatever. So it's supposed to be aligned with that. And then the Nile River has moved, but it's originally supposed to be lined up, whatever. It's some, I forgot what it is now. Whatever it is, it's the... like this is a hunter, that Orion belt is on the hunter, and he's got like a bow that he shoots an arrow with, which of course refers, but there's, it refers to the Antichrist, a bow with no arrows and all this stuff. So it refers also again to the Antichrist. But I'm just now realizing this as I'm telling you this, as a matter of fact, about that part. But, you know, the Nile River, it was in line with the bow or whatever, the hunter's bow. So the Lord had told me to study Orion's Belt, and then he gave me a word separately, which I made a video about, which the judgment of the people that were that take the mark and all that comes out of Orion, comes out of the Big Dipper. And then I didn't have any idea what it meant or any connection, because I'd been looking at the Egyptology stuff, looking for some connection with the Big Dipper. Couldn't find any. But I just had studied now, and with this thing I found out about the colors of the pyramid, I also found out that, I made a video about this too, the temple at Luxor. There is a temple, I forgot the name of it, in Luxor, that is dedicated to the human as God. I've talked about this before. The Louvre is patterned after that. God is, a man is a God. And inside there's even a pineal gland on the wall. Even that Egyptian eye with a little line coming down that you see, that is actually the pineal gland. If you cut a brain in half down the middle and look at the side of the brain, the pineal gland. And that's what these New Age people and some people that claim to be Christians on YouTube talk about, the third eye, the pineal gland. That's New Age stuff. That's demonic, satanic. It is not for Christians. FYI. Anyway, so that temple and that area there is patterned off the Big Dipper. That's just some new information I found out. So all of the things, these things I'm telling you confirm what I've been trying to tell you guys from the beginning, that the Lord has had me. All the videos I did about duality and all that stuff when I was on the Revelation News Radio and all that, and the Sabbath Live Radio, whatever. The point is that when the lie of Satan for people to take the mark for the kingdom of the Antichrist, the lie will be that you can become a god. When you take that mark, you will become as God. Just like Satan told Eve, when you eat the fruit, you'll become as God. And that's the same thing. Taking that mark is like eating the fruit. And it will be your fall, the downfall. But in this case, there's no redemption from taking the mark, because you have this DNA change. That's a whole other thing. That's a scientific way of looking at it. You will become a beast. You'll think you're becoming a god, like the temple there in Luxor. I forgot the name of that temple. I can't think of it right now. But anyway, no, but instead you will be becoming a beast. You'll be a freak of nature, like the Nephilim, a freak, neither man nor beast, but a freak. So like the Sphinx, a freak. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless. Let me cut this off. It's already like 2 o'clock in the morning here. I've been bonding and praying and talking with the house mom and dad, and then the new house mom and dad. So we've been planning, talking, praying, discussing all these plans, and praise God. I told them that I would get on here and get a hold of you guys, because we got to get this stuff done, and we need to do it right now. And, you know, I can only go as everything comes together. These things just happen. When you're following God, it's not a business. That's the problem that some business people make, treating it like a business, talking about a business. This is not a business. We can use business practices, but it's not a business, because we're dealing with people's hearts here and God's timing in people's hearts. Like the new house mom and dad, their hearts had to be right to answer the call that God already gave them, and God's timing and all that stuff. These are not things that you can plan in business. That's the problem with all those churches in the States. That's why people who watch my videos and say, people aren't doing this in the States. Well, you know why? Because they're business people. Joel Osteen is worried about building his own kingdom, making a bigger church and getting more money and all that. He's making a business. Now, some rich businessman in the States told me, because we were doing that coconuts and stuff, that I was making a business. No, it's not a business. That money goes for Joshua's ministry. This is not a business. This is to generate revenue to be a good steward of God's money for the purposes of the kingdom, not for the purpose necessarily of making money. As an example, like I said, the man who is overseeing our coconut farm, it's not a Christian. So God's purpose, just as important as any profit that the farm would make, is the salvation of the man managing it and the workers on the coconut farm. What good does a man to gain the whole world and lose his soul, as Jesus asked? Or what would a man give in exchange for his soul? It's much more important for these house moms and dads and the orphans and then the workers and all that to become Christians and serve the Lord and go to heaven than it is about money. That is nothing. It's just a necessary, money is just a necessary means to do the things that God wants us to do. That's it. It's only an instrument. And that's all it will ever be. Jesus said you cannot serve two gods. You will love one and hate the other, or hate one and love the other. You cannot serve God and money. God bless you guys. I'm going to start preaching, and it's already 25 minutes. Love you guys. I'll be back, and I'm going to go in about the pyramid stuff that I just talked about, and then I'm going to pray for people. I got about 50 people's names on the list to give a word for. God bless.